Hello, hello, and thank you for tuning into Music Men and My Mental. I am C. Devone, your host, and we are talking about all things in your career, your relationship, and your overall health. So how are you doing today? You know, I like to start with a little bit of homework, and the homework today is check your energy. If we can even put a reminder in our phone for daily to put the reminder to check your energy. I was in Marshall's the other day. And I was just feeling down and out, and I was just like, oh, fix your energy, like, just fix it. And as soon as I, like, kind of, like, pepped up, I didn't smile or anything, but I just wanted to be, like, more open. So I open up, and this lady turns around, and she says, are you, she has a, listen, my bad Caribbean accent, or are you from Brooklyn? And I'm like, no, but I live here. And she's just like, is there a two family, you know, I'm looking for a two bedroom apartment. And I'm like, why is she talking to me? Is she crazy? And she goes into like her house burnt down. And yeah, her house has burnt down. And like, but she has like kids who are in college and she wants them to like have a place to go to when she gets back and how much she used to like pay in her place. And I'm like, okay, why does she want to talk to me about this out of all the people? Because the Marshall's line is long as hell, if you guys don't know, in Brooklyn at Atlantic Terminal. But I felt like my energy was welcoming. No matter what I was going through, it was welcoming enough for her to want to share, or maybe put her, it could have been a burden or something that was on her heart, or she just needed someone to talk to at that moment. And she just kept telling me more things and asking me, and I don't know what her situation was. I don't know if she was saying, not saying. It could have been, I don't know. But the reality was she wanted someone to talk to. And when once I checked my energy to put whatever I was going through aside, I was welcoming. And I felt like what she was going through was way worse than what I was going through, you know? So just check your energy. Put a little daily reminder, even when you just like, just it could be any time of the day, 8 o'clock in the morning, every day, just check your energy, see how you're feeling, what you're giving off to the universe. So with that said, let's get to the show. I have a beautiful, beautiful soul. I met her, and as soon as I met her, I was like, I want her on my show. I got to get to know her. It is Quiana Richardson from It's Fitness, Bitch.
Yes. Hello.
So, okay. So it's, what is It's Fitness, Bitch?
Well, thank you for having me on the show. You were also a beautiful spirit when I met you. And you just, and you did our party. You killed it. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
I DJ'd. So that was technically the launch of the party.
Yes. Okay. Yes.
So it was the launch and it was fabulous. I mean, details to the nine, to the napkins, to the fabulous video, the artwork. I said, I have to know her. She's fabulous. So yes. So what is It's Fitness, Bitch?
Yes. So It's Fitness, Bitch is a brand that creates innovative ways to get fitness and nutrition into the marketplace. Our goal is to think of the extraordinary, not the ordinary. We have everything from bad bitch cardio classes to bad girl cardio class chair classes. We also do house party workshops. We also have branded Fit Bitch gear. You know, it's really geared where it's like you put it on and you like feel kind of powerful. You feel good. And it kind of stands out to people. So it's really for the person that wants to do different things with their fitness and nutrition, not just the mundane. And then we also have lifestyle tips and lifestyle stories on our website as well. So this is my brand. It's been an idea in my mind for like 4 years and it's finally launched. So I'm very excited. Very excited.
I am excited for you as well. And you have all this gear and the video is so amazing. So, yes. And you actually teach the classes.
Yes, I do. I teach the classes. You know, we also have other girls that teach as well, but the bad girl cardio style is a particular style because I want cardio, dance, it's attitude, it's toning, it's strutting. It's really all about fun. Like when people come to class, I want them to feel like they're at a dance party, not necessarily a regular fitness class. So yeah, I do teach most of them, but you know, we're going to be having classes coming up soon in Chicago and, and of course in New York all the time. So yeah, I teach them, but we're also going to have, you know, girls that are going to know the sort of bad girl cardio way. So
okay, so let's start from the top. This idea is beautiful and it started as an idea.
It did.
And so
it
your background was in PR at first.
It was. So I graduated from undergrad and I ended up getting a job with a big corporation doing events and PR. And I just, you know, coming from being an athlete in college, I just hated it. I was just miserable. And I was traveling and I was going to Super Bowls, MLB All-Star Games, and you would think it was like this beautiful, beautiful experience. But like 1 year in, I was just like, this is not
What did you hate about it?
I think for me, it was just the mundane of knowing what I was going to do every single day. It did not feel like a challenge or like I was going to grow. It just felt like, this is what you're going to do every single day. And even though I was traveling and doing events.
I was going to say, because it's a job that has a lot of, perks.
A lot of perks. Right.
Every day wasn't really technically the same, but just wasn't for you.
To me, it felt like, it was like one event ended, it was on to the next. Mm. So even though it was a different event, it was the same process over and over again. I found myself, I didn't know a lot of my friends. I was gone half the month. I couldn't really have a relationship. I just was never really around. And I felt like I wanted to have more of a life, to be honest. So I was very overworked, underpaid, which at big corporations, sometimes when you first start out, that's just how it is. And I just was like, this is not for me.
But it takes a special person to like have all this like glitter in front of them and then just realize that your soul was not being fed because anyone else would say, are you crazy?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
And you just, and so the story is you told me, but you know, off camera. So you came in one day and was like,
I was like going on my third year there. And I was like, you know what? I just woke up to this one day and I just went into work and I was just like, and I just kind of grabbed my purse and walked right back out and never went back.
Did you send an email?
I didn't send nothing. I feel like they got the memo that I was done.
You didn't have any conflict with anyone?
No, not really. Not really. I just felt
your soul said it's time to go.
Yes. You know how I knew it? I was at a Super Bowl. I remember I was at the Super Bowl. I had been working all week prior to this day. I was sitting at the Super Bowl. And you would have think I was at like a little like flag football game. I was so unhappy and so miserable. And you know, everyone around me was like happy. And I was just like, why am I so unhappy at like these big events? And I was like, I think it's the job. I think it's the job. So I walked in one day. It was something told me to do it. And I quit and I didn't look back. So.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then from there, you just decided like, you had to do something that was completely different or you had to focus on like what was going to, through your brain to do something so drastic and then say, okay, this is what's happening next.
I just felt like if I didn't do it, I would have gotten stuck. You know, sometimes you just get stuck in like, this is my life. This is what it is. And I was like, this is not what I want to do for the rest of my life. And I don't know what came over me that day to just be like, I'm done. But I was like, if I don't do this, if I don't ever leave, I'm going to be here forever. Because sometimes we do get stuck in the normalcy of a a paycheck every 2 weeks and benefits. And that moment I was like, I have to do this because I am going to get stuck. And a lot of us sometimes get stuck. And what I realize is that I think it's really fear that holds us back because you never know what that next step's going to lead to.
Right.
And for some reason that day, I just wasn't afraid. And I just said, this is it. I'm done.
Wow.
And I just knew I wanted, because like I said, I'm into fitness. So I was running track in college. And then to go from like working out 3-4 hours a day to just sitting down 8 hours a day. And even though in Vince, you don't really sit down, but it still was very like mundane to me. I just wanted something different. Didn't really know at the time what I wanted, but I just knew I wanted something different.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then you say, so you went back to school? Or
yeah. Then I end up eventually going back to school. I got into real estate because I felt like I was good with people. You know, with events, you have to love people. You have to be good with all kind of personalities. And so I met someone in my time doing events and he's like, you should really think about real estate. You're very personable.
I'm so fascinated by real estate, but we'll talk about that off camera.
We'll talk about that off camera. You're very personable. You kind of can create your own hours. And I was like, I feel like this would be perfect for me. And that's what I did. So I went back, I got my master's in construction management here in New York. And then I got into real estate. At the same time though, I launched my first fitness business, which was not as Fitness Bitch. It was My Healthy Sport, which was a personal training business. And doing real estate gave me freed up the time to work on my business now. So I was doing things that were a little bit more fulfilling to me, to my soul. And that's kind of how my transition kind of got into kind of where I'm at today in a way. Mm-hmm.
And you mentioned something about a vegan bar that you had. So you've had a personal training company.
I have.
Then you went on to have a vegan like protein bar or something?
Yes, it was a vegan. So I'm a vegetarian. Okay. I have been for a while. And I created this vegan bar that now they're everywhere. But mm-hmm. back then it wasn't really a lot of them. Mm-hmm. So I created this bar. I sold it on my site and a bigger company bought out the recipe from me.
Wow.
And that kind of happened on a whim. I was just at a party kind of talking about my healthy sport. And I sent samples to a company trying to actually have them distribute my bars for me, make them and distribute them. And then they end up saying, you know, we kind of like the sales that you're doing. Would you be interested in like selling these ingredients to us? And I said, absolutely.
Hey.
So that happened. I sold that. And then my healthy sport kind of dissolved because I think I was just at that time looking to kind of move on from it. I felt like I sold a piece of it. I've kind of taken it as far as I think I could. I was supposed to. And then it kind of dissolved kind of on its own.
Got you.
Yeah.
And then the birth of It's Fitness Bitch.
The birth of It's Fitness Bitch came. You know, I think being in New York, you go through
New York
phases.
Can do some things to
you. Yes, it can. Yes, it can. But I think going through New York and going through experiences and going through just life, you change, you know. And so I got into running marathons. So I ran. Yeah. So I've run. Wow. Yeah, I've run 4 marathons now. Yeah. So I got into, I know.
A year or like?
No, like just four overall. I've run 4 in my life.
Well,
yes.
I can't speak English. I want to run a marathon.
We have to talk. I will tell you how to train.
I'm so scared.
Be, you know what? I was scared too.
I'm scared about my toenails. That's what I'm scared about.
It happens.
Oh, Jesus. Not sold.
But it just depends on your body, right? I think if you train right and you eat right while training, you should have no problems. Mm-hmm. But I did, again, it's that fear. I did it because I was like, I want to experience this and see how it is. And so I just started doing things that I felt like I wanted to do, something it called me to do. And it's Fitness Bitch came just from a place of, I wanted to have a website or a business where girls can feel like it's different, it's cool, it's edgy, it's not the same mundane kind of classes. I just wanted to have a business that was servicing more to people that just wanted to have fun. Didn't feel like it was like, oh, I have to go to class today. Like, oh, I have to go to the gym today. I want people to be excited to come to something. And because I have a dance background as well. So that's kind of how Bad Girl Cardio started. I started just teaching it to my friends and renting out studios on my own. And they were like, this is actually a pretty good class. You should think about continuing this on. And so, like I said, I had this idea 4 years ago, but it's not until now that it actually has become like a full-fledged business.
Right.
I just was kind of letting the universe kind of, I think, lead me to where I'm at.
Right.
So it was like a slow process to get here.
And the name, why the name?
You know, people ask me this all the time. They're like, where did Fitness Bitch come from? I said, because sometimes you have to be a bitch about things to get things done in life, in relationships. And why not about fitness? I mean, sometimes you're going to have to work hard to get the results you want or to get to where you want to be. So I think Fitness Bitch is more empowering, kind of taking, because it can sometimes be a negative word, obviously.
Right.
Taking it more into endearing to be like, yeah, I'm a bitch. Like, I killed that. I killed that workout. I killed that class. I did that. So I wanted to be more empowering. And I thought, well, what's something that will get people's attention?
Right.
Fitness Bitch does that.
Right.
And again, this is something that kind of naturally.
Can men and women be a part of Fitness Bitch?
Absolutely. Okay. Absolutely. All men and women can take the class. It's really all about fun.
Okay.
And I kind of teach based on, who is in the class. So the moves are really simple. The attitude is really simple. It's fun. It's dancing. It's a lot of toning. So you don't feel like, you're just in a room full of just girls and I can't do anything. So yeah, it's open to everyone.
Well, something I know you mentioned that is like super special about. You have the attire, you have the classes. They can go to your website and also find, what's going on from everything.
Yes.
But 10% of the proceeds, you said, goes to a foundation.
Yes. Okay. Yes. So about a year ago, I lost my father. heart attack. Very random. It happened.
So it was unexpected.
Very unexpected. Mm-hmm. I'm an only child. Mm-hmm. So obviously it was a big, big shock. So I told my dad this idea about 4 years ago. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And being a father, he was like, well, I don't understand. Like, what is this? I don't understand. I was like, Dad, trust me. It's going to be cool. He passed away. And I was actually going to launch maybe a month after he passed. I had planned to launch it like in January. Mm-hmm. And then he passed December 5th. Mm. And it just kind of broke my world. Like, mm-hmm. I was just... not worries about fit bitch or anything. I was just like, I'm just done. I'm mm-hmm. gonna just move home with my mom. Mm-hmm. And then over time.
Did you actually get up and move, or you kept your place here?
I kept my place here, and I was home for like 2 months.
Okay.
And my mom was like, you have to go back. You know, your dad would not want you to just sit here and do mm-hmm. nothing. Mm-hmm. You have to get this business out because you told him about it, and he wouldn't want you to just sit here and mm-hmm. do nothing. Mm-hmm. So I came back. I've gotten stronger. I've gone to a lot of therapy. Therapy helps. Mm-hmm. Don't think it doesn't. And so when I launched, I wanted to have a piece of my dad, a part mm-hmm. of it, because he's the reason I'm able to do businesses and mm-hmm. accomplish my dreams. He's the reason why I'm actually in New York, both mm-hmm. of my parents. Mm-hmm. So the Daniel W. Richardson Scholarship Fund is called the Daniel's Daughters Fund. Mm-hmm. And we will give one deserving young woman in Chicago who shows fearless and fabulousness in her community and her mm-hmm. education. We will help them with money to go off to college. So 10% of every class, every workshop, every mm-hmm. gear that we sell goes into this fund. And mm-hmm. then starting December of next year, we give out a scholarship to a young girl who is deserving. Yeah. So I'm trying to turn something that kind of was tragic and try mm-hmm. to turn it into a positive light. Mm-hmm. To push not only me, but to push other young women forward. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, I think when someone believes in you, you can believe in yourself. And he really believed in me. Mm-hmm. And he believed in a lot of young people. So I want to push that forward.
Good. I love that. So you can work out, you can give back. Mm-hmm. All right. So but let's talk about you. Let's talk about how you were doing. I mean, and one thing you said was like you went to therapy, which is like
still in it.
As this show is all about really like taking care of definitely your physical, but your mental health first before you can go into your body.
Absolutely.
And just knowing that you are wise enough. I mean, clearly you are wise, because when you walked out that job, I was like, okay, you're wiser than most people, because you had the foreshadow to say, even though this can look really good, I'm not going to be happy in the long run.
Right.
You have to foreshadow to say, you know what, let me get therapy. Not, you know, I don't know what state you were in, but like most people wait so long and wait till it gets to the most critical point before they go to therapy.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
So was it just recommended? You just knew that you had to do it, or?
When it kind of happened, being an only child, mm-hmm. I just took it so hard. Mm-hmm. I mean, I didn't work out. I didn't eat. I'm be honest. It was like 2 weeks. I didn't eat anything because mm-hmm. I was just so drained mm-hmm. and trying to emotionally deal with the fact that a man that I knew loved me no matter what mm-hmm. is now no longer going to be here. So mm-hmm. it felt very empty. Mm-hmm. And I knew I was like, if I'm going to be able to go back to New York, I have to get into therapy mm-hmm. because I need to emotionally talk to someone about this every mm-hmm, week because mm-hmm. it just felt like it was so bottled up. Mm-hmm. And if I just would have kept it bottled up, I would mm-hmm. still be in Chicago in my mom's house. Just
right,
sitting
right,
there.
Right, right.
So I knew that if I was going to be okay physically, I had to emotionally get myself together mm-hmm. to deal with a death. You know? And people grieve differently. My mm-hmm. therapist said people grieve differently. Some people take it hard. Mm-hmm. Some people don't cry at all. Mm-hmm. For me, it was like just outburst crying and mm-hmm. and just sadness. And I was just like, I have to be able to function every day.
Was this your first time in therapy?
Absolutely not. Oh, no.
Okay. So
I'm a therapist.
Okay,
oh,
okay,
yes.
Okay. No, I was curious because yes. like, you know, it is so commendable when it's your first time to go, but like yeah. knowing that you needed a certain different type of therapy, you needed to maybe see someone different, or you were like, let me ante up on this therapy.
Yes. Yeah. I went to a specific grievance counselor. I found a grievance counselor specifically. And, you know, she has been great because it helps me think about like all the little questions I have every week. Just mm-hmm. like, well, am I doing the right thing? Am I you know, am I, should I still be here? Should I still go home? Mm-hmm. I mean, these are thoughts that just run through your mind mm-hmm. when you just have like a piece of you gone mm-hmm. and trying to deal with that on your own. Mm-hmm. It's just, it's not, for me, I knew it wasn't going to work mm-hmm. unless, because I needed to talk to someone other than my mother, mm-hmm. my grandmother, my cousin, who of mm-hmm. course they're going to comfort you. Mm-hmm. But it's helpful when you get someone's perspective of it to be like, well, your dad loved you. So mm-hmm. you knew what he wanted you to do. He wouldn't mm-hmm. want you to give up. So mm-hmm. why would you give up?
And were you like a daddy's girl as well?
I was. Like, okay. I was very much a daddy's girl. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's still hard. Mm-hmm. Every day it's hard. It's mm-hmm. hard to deal with a loss, any kind type of loss.
So since we're going into the holidays, yes. like, do you have any tools or tips for people like who, like my grandmother, I was mentioning my grandmother passed about a year ago.
Yeah.
And like Christmas and Thanksgiving is like so hard. Like yes. now we've gotten like, cause it was like right around Mother's Day. So like I took over Mother's Day, like immediately before anyone else would say, no, we're not going to. So I did it really differently. But like now it's just like, it's just not the same. It doesn't yeah. have as much energy and right. we're trying, but like what tools do you, or tips would you give to someone, you mm-hmm. know, during this time when you are still like having a difficulty, like what would you say to them?
I mean, I would say that it's important to be around family. Like mm-hmm. I know for me at Christmas time, it's the first Christmas I'm going to have without them Thanksgiving. Mm-hmm. It's important for me to go home to Chicago and be around family. Mm-hmm. I think that it's good to also talk to people about what you're feeling mm-hmm. in moments when you're having low times, mm. because I know we can sometimes just talk to ourselves about it over and over and over again and kind of feel like it's just kind of getting nowhere. But it's good to get out, I think, whatever you're feeling mm-hmm. or whether it's sadness or happiness. Mm-hmm. And then also I think about just the memories, like mm-hmm. the happy times with him make me happy. Mm-hmm. And I think about the songs we sang and sort of the laughter that we had. And it kind of puts a smile on my face mm-hmm. now. Mm-hmm. You know, I think when it first happened, no, but around the holidays, I remember the Christmases that we had and just the things that we used to share.
Right.
Those are things that I think have comforted me around mm-hmm. holidays and birthdays mm-hmm. Of the, you know, in the memory of that person.
Good. Yeah. Yeah. I agree. So you do have to be around family and it's super important. And
yeah,
like if some people say like, oh, I don't want to be around, you know, X, Y, Z, or they're right. not fair. And it is important because also I feel like, I think I was mentioning like, you have now an angel and a protector and like, right. I feel like they're watching. So it's like, you know, it's like, what would Jesus do? Like, what would grandma do? You know, right. you're like, okay, it's Thanksgiving. Okay, right. I'm here on the island. Are you mad at me? Or like, right, right. do you want me to be with my mother? Or do you want me to be at Christmas, you know,
right, right.
making her dinner? So I think it is super important because so many people, you know, have different relationships with their family.
Absolutely.
And you don't know how it goes. But right, if you right. can, I always say, like, try to be with, even if it's one person, like, it's really agree. Helpful.
Right.
So we spoke about the career, which was, I still can't believe, like, getting up and just, like, gonna just launch amazing companies that strive and thrive.
Right.
And then, you know, health, like, you know, you've always just been like a person who's just been in the gym and been mm-hmm. healthy and launching a fitness, you know, company. Mm-hmm. So relationships, let's go into that. Like, you know, you spoke about, you know, the relationship with your family, which is very important. And I know some of that can trickle into your actual like other relationships, because
absolutely.
I know a lot of my friends who are like single children, they have a very different perspective on like when they have like their mom and their dad or just like they're a daddy's girl and they're a yeah. single child. They have a lot more demands for their, I don't know if that's, I mean, it sounds kind of fucked up. They have more standards. I don't know. Maybe I'm the youngest child and okay. my father wasn't really in the household, mm-hmm. but my friends who were, you know, only children and their fathers were present in the household or just having a daddy present in the household, they have very different standards from what I had. Not saying I had none, right. but I was like, girl, I was like, he needs to have teeth. They were like, he ain't got, I'm just kidding. I'm like, he ain't gotta have no teeth. Just kidding. Anyway, so like just tell me like, oh, so are you single?
I am single. Mm-hmm. I am single. I think.
And New York City is hard out here, girl.
It's very hard to date in New York. I mean, it's hard. Okay, it's hard to date anywhere. I'm not going to say that.
Okay, New York versus Chicago.
Oh, it's apples and oranges. Apples and oranges. You know, it's funny because
you didn't spend like most of your adult life in Chicago.
I really didn't. Okay. Like when I left for college, I haven't moved back to Chicago. So I've been away for years now. Mm-hmm. But you know, it's interesting you say that because some of my friends in Chicago think that dating is hard for them in Chicago.
Right.
And half of them are like married in relationships. Half of them are still single. Mm. So, you know, yeah. So I'm single and I think it's definitely been by choice definitely this last year because I don't think I'll be a fun date right now because, you know, I've been trying to grieve. I've been trying to just deal with the loss of my father. Mm-hmm. And my therapist said, yeah, I mean, if it would be hard for me to, I think, open my heart right now because I don't think I have a lot to really give right now, to be really honest. And, you know,
the inventory and you were like, not right now.
But
a nice guy came along or someone you were interested in, you just feel like the timing is just not good for you.
I think the timing is kind of not good for me right now. But that's smart. I think that's good for me because I know, right? I don't want to try to date someone and I'm still grieving or there's some days I'm still sad. Mm. And then, you know, I can't say it's because of business because as women, we're always going to have business and work and things like that, right? It's not launching the business. But I think, you know, I think I'm getting stronger every day. Mm-hmm. And I think once I'm in a place to wanna, you know, dress up and put on fresh makeup for somebody, then I think I'll get there. But now I feel like what am I going to talk about? Mm. Am I going to be a fun date? Mm. Am I going to be, is my heart really open? Mm-hmm. You know, and I think 50% probably not.
Gotcha. So you do think you will come around or do you think like, you know what, I just don't want to add this stress to my life.
Right. And men are stressful. No shade. You know what I'm saying?
So, no, trust me.
They are stressful. And, you know, dating takes time. You know, relationships take time.
This is actually the good time probably to date you. Because, you know what? No. I always say that, like, grieving is when, because then you can actually get to know them at a more steady pace than like going on dinners and dates. And also like in crisis mode, when there's a crisis. So grieving in crisis, if the person is serious, if they're like, wham, bam, thank you, fuck boy.
And I'm not interested.
You are going to spot them more because you're not interested.
Right.
But if a person actually genuinely wants to like get to know you, maybe if it's just a friend or like, you know, an acquaintance, and they're going at a pace that's like, how are you doing?
Right.
How are you dealing with this? Oh, I know that, you know, you've been, you know, your business just launched. I just picked up some vegan cupcakes for you. You know what I mean? Like, come on, you know, like if they're doing that, then you're going to be more like, oh, that's nice. That's thoughtful.
You know, it's funny you say that because I do have like a friend that he checks on me. I mean, no, I have a friend that, you know, checks. Are you all right? Are you good? But, you know, it doesn't go.
He's trying to get the drink.
It doesn't go.
He's trying to swoop in.
Even while I'm grieving? That's messed up. You messed up.
But it's true. Because it's the perfect time. I mean, it's so fucked up. But what is it like the wedding and the funeral is like the people that are coming in and they're like, because people's vulnerabilities are different.
That's
so you're vulnerable. You don't want a man. You don't need to get married. You're good.
Right.
But like, you're more looking at the thoughtfulness of someone being around
you. I am.
Understanding that like, I just want to watch TV, whatever.
Right.
And then after you start getting a little healthy, a little stronger, I ain't coming for the little okie doke, get a sush, you know? I'm not saying that he's doing this for anyone.
Right.
But that, and then like weddings, because everyone's like looking at love and they're saying, oh my gosh, just I just know what she went through when she was looking for a man. I just see her so happy. I just want that. And then, you know, some guys like, hey girl, I got you a glass of champagne. And then you're like, I've always wanted to get married. I've known him since. And then now you, look,
I mean,
just saying.
Okay, you're not wrong. You're not wrong. But I think because I'm so like, thank you for checking on me. And I'm not like, you know, begging to go out.
And they're just dropping the seeds.
They're just dropping little gems.
So that plant can grow, honey.
Is that what you think is happening?
I'm telling you. Is
this happening to you? Because you said maybe. Your grandmother. No, oh, yeah. It's happening to you too?
No, but, no, well, are here's the friends? Thing. So here's the thing. When my grandmother died, I already knew this guy. I did not want him in my life.
Okay.
But.
Oh.
I had him around just because he lived really close by. And I was just like, okay. You know what? I just need a drink with this guy.
Okay.
Granted, he was a bit of an alcoholic. So I probably shouldn't have had a drink with him. Like, you know, you call your whole friends when you want to do whole shit. You call your alcoholic friends when you want to drink.
Yes.
That's what I did.
Okay, makes sense now.
Dumb shit. Makes sense 101.
Now. Okay.
So I went and we had drinks. And then, like, I just felt worse. Like, being around him was worse. Mm. And he didn't come in and do, like, the swoop and the thoughtfulness. He was more like just...
You want to go out and drink.
You want to go out and drink.
Oh,
you
know, I got you.
Or like, hey, you want to have sex or just something like.
Oh.
And yeah.
Oh.
So.
We're just asking like that now?
Right.
Okay.
And it was just like, oh, okay. Like, you know, my guard was up.
Right.
But then there was one moment where I started just testing because I already had been in a relationship with him. We already had broken up. But
oh, okay.
It was, you know, it takes, well, you know, when you really break up, it takes a good year.
It takes a while.
For you to like really break up.
It does. You're right.
So. He was around, and then I just kept saying, let me just ask him these little things. Something just kept going in my head. Let me ask him little things of thought.
Right.
That to see, can you just go to the store for me to get this? Can you just, he just like massage right here?
Right.
And he just kept saying like no, and just like things that were just like really wasn't fair for me.
Right.
I just felt like he just was there for the free meal because I cook. Like I love cooking. You come to my house, I love to make people feel comfortable.
Right.
And I'm like, is he here for the free meal? Because he, like, I didn't know. Girl, lie to you not. I had asked him something, and it was like my last question. Like, I was down to, like, I'm going to kick him out in 5 minutes. But, he had no clue.
Let me get this question right.
And then I was sitting down, and I asked him to do something. And he said, like, no, or, like, something. And I was like, okay. And literally something fell in my house.
Mm-mm.
Didn't know what it was.
Wow.
Never found what it was. It was the loudest thump. It wasn't any person upstairs, downstairs, nothing. It was something in my house.
Oh, wow.
And he was like, we were like, what was that? And he was like, I was like, I don't know. And something in my heart had no fear, no scariness. It was just like, I got you. I felt the presence. Because my grandmother was like, listen here.
He got to go.
He ain't shit. He got to go.
Right.
And she would always say that. And that moment I said, okay, I have a protector. I have an angel.
Right.
And I was like, listen. And we never spoke after that.
Are you serious?
He had to go. I was dead ass. I was New York dead ass, son.
Wait, he never checked on you or nothing afterwards?
We had like a, you know what, this is now. He was like, he sent like a letter of exchange and it was more like, I need to let you free anyway. Nigga, goodbye. You were garbage
anyway. You were garbage, right.
And there's three sides to every story. Like,
right.
Maybe I was garbage at the time. Maybe in the middle, it just was the wrong time for both people.
Right. Because
that could happen.
Right.
But grieving and crisis are when you actually can really, really come through
people.
For the person that you think is right for you.
That's like, true. That's
you know,
true.
If it's just, like I said, trying to have sex, but if you like always like that person, like, you've always cared and you just want to like, you're naturally just going to want to be there for people when they need you, especially if a person like, I can tell from you, you don't need nobody to do anything for you. You seem very independent. You seem like, you know, you got it together. So if you have that little inkling of like, oh, I'm going to ask you again if you ate. And then the second day you tell me, oh, I haven't ate. I'm coming to your house as my friend, as a lover to be like, hey, girl, I got some pad thai for you. I know you don't like the nuts. I put them on the side.
Right.
Now you're like, dang, that's my homegirl.
She cares.
Friend.
Right.
Same thing.
Yeah, that's true.
So that's what I'm saying. I'm not saying, now y'all better not slide in her DMs talking about, hey girl, I got some Chloe cupcakes
for
you.
Right.
You know,
vegan cupcakes. Don't do that.
I'm just saying, but it's just like that. So you said, okay, what was the last relationship you were in?
So last one was a DJ.
Lord Jesus.
And
listen, DJs, don't be messing up for everybody. It's funny because I was like, I don't date DJs.
Now, why is this? Because you know, have you seen too much of bullshit or?
No, that's not the case. Okay. It's because, so for me, I dated DJs and it wasn't anything bad in particular. It's okay. That for me in the moment for what I want long term, I already have, you have some stable income, you have some unstable income.
Right, right.
I think that was hard for me. Even dating entrepreneurs can be like really hard. So for me as a DJ, and then it was just like, maybe just my insecurities of like, if you're always on the go or like, if I don't feel confident in you just naturally and you're a DJ and, oh wait, are you drinking all the time? Are you eating well? Are you taking care of your body? Yeah. How are your finances when, listen, you can make $10,000 in a month and the next month make $10.
Right.
Are you okay with that? How are you managing your money? You know, so.
Right.
Am I going to be the leader of the household? Are we going to be in partnership?
Right.
Or do I just have to take over everything?
Right.
So that's why I just had my taste with them and said, oh, that's cool. Let's be friends.
Right.
You know?
Okay, makes sense.
But what was your experience like?
Well, you know, I met him through a dating app, which my friends encouraged me to
do. Exactly. I think there's nothing wrong with dating apps.
It was nothing wrong with it. You know, I wasn't.
Have you been online before?
Not really.
That was your first time?
That was like my first time being online. Because my friends were like, listen, I'm not a big dater. I'm just not a big dater. I'm a relationship person. If I get in a relationship, I'm getting a relationship. If I'm not, I'm just not.
Okay.
And I'm just
How
not.
How you in a relationship if you don't
I
date?
I mean, like my thing is like, I'll meet you if I'm out. Like if I'm out an event or something or networking, I'll meet you cool. If I meet through a friend, through work, cool.
Okay.
I'm just not a online dater. Mm-hmm. Nothing wrong with it. Let me be clear on that. I have tons of friends that met people online. It just kind of wasn't my thing. So my friend's like, why don't you try it? It's something different. It's cool. My friend has just met someone online. Also, was also a DJ.
She was a DJ?
No. My friend also dated a DJ. Met a DJ online.
Let me find out. I know. Just praying on women. Like,
I know.
Yeah, girl, let me play you a love song.
It's bad. But yeah, her experience wasn't as bad as mine. But yeah, so we met online. Mm-hmm. He was cool. Very cool. Mm-hmm. Little hints of things kind of off. Like he would just be like, so he would come over, we would like have a day, we'd chill, and then he'd be like, yeah, so like I gotta go home because I gotta like practice my DJing at like 8 a.m. every day, and then my phone gonna be on Do Not Disturb, you feel me? So like so like you couldn't call him, you could, but he would get the text, and he would like do that all day. And I would be like, so at first I was like, okay.
All day, like throughout the 9 to 5 day?
Like a 9 to 5 day. And he would just be like, I guess practicing. And my friends were like, that shit don't sound right. And I was like, I
do not know his schedule. Right. But I think that's just a personality thing. Like,
I think it was a trait
to be alone. If you're not lying, because
that's the thing.
The first reaction is like, okay, you're just telling lies.
You're lying.
And then the other one is like, okay, maybe you are just a person who just needs to focus on their craft, but like, or in that discipline, that's super key to have an 8 a.m. discipline. But to say like, I'm not going to communicate with you or at least like from 8 to 10, I practice. And you know, like, for instance, if you date a guy in the gym or you know that you're in fitness class, like not to call you. That makes sense.
That makes sense.
But just very bad communicator.
He was kind of a bad communicator. And I would be like, well, okay, so if people are trying to book you, how do they get in contact with you if your phone's on Do Not Disturb? He's like, well, they could email me or like they could like text me. And I'd be like, I was like, okay, this is like red flag number one. I was like, okay, okay. My friends are like, he's lying. Mm-hmm. They're like, yeah, he's lying. You need to go over.
Did he give you liar vibes? That's what I want to know. Like, is he like giving you like,
because
you could smell the shit from a mile away.
I feel like he gave me crazy vibes. I felt like he had a little tick. Like something was kind of off. Mm-hmm. And so I went to his house in the Bronx and like, he had like two roommates.
Okay.
So I was like, okay, so you're not living with a chick. Like I thought maybe, I was thinking like, okay, maybe you're in a relationship and you're just trying to get home at a certain time.
Right.
That's not what it was.
That's exactly, okay.
Yeah. Point. So I went down, I was like,
I don't know why I didn't think that. Cause once the weirdness of it to me said, I'm just weird versus like, I got a whole wife at home.
Right. Okay. And he was internationally DJing for like years. Then he recently came back and he had a situation where like he could stay at his friend's house whenever he just felt like it, I guess. Another weird situation. I was like, okay, fine.
Car.
Then So then we'd be out and then like he'd spend the night maybe. And then he'd be like, so yeah, I got to like get home at like 6 a.m. Like, can you drive me home? Or because I don't want to like take the subway. It's like too many people. Blah, blah.
Bish.
I was like.
And your first time you're like, oh no, it's cool. Or the first time, and then.
First time I was like, okay, cool.
Because then after that, you're driving him everywhere.
Right. Right. The first time I was like, oh, I can take you home. No problem. I have to be up anyway. I have stuff to do. No problem. It became like a ritual. He'd be like, well, can you take me home? I would be like, yeah, I can't.
From the Brooklyn to the Bronx?
Yes. I would be like, no, I'm not taking you home. Ugh. Take an Uber.
2019.
Or the subway. Oh, and I would be like, okay. And my friends were like, listen, I don't know a dude that gets up at 5 a.m. and is like, yeah, I got to go.
Just to go home and practice.
Just to go home and practice. Mm. So something was off, right? Mm-hmm. So we dated for like six, seven months. And then I had to have surgery. Surgery. And I was like, listen, I have to have surgery. Someone has to come with me because mm-hmm. afterwards I'll be kind of out of it. And I spoke to him. He was doing a DJ gig in Philly. Uh-huh. He called me. He's like, hey, you know, the gig went good. I'm on my way back. I was like, all right, I'll see you the next day. My surgery was the following week. I haven't heard from him since.
Wait.
So
run it back. Run it back.
Let's remix it. Let's do a remix.
He never showed up to the surgery.
He never showed up to surgery. Never responded to a text, a call.
Oh, because the last message was, you're supposed to meet me. He already confirmed that he was going to be.
Oh, the doctor had his name and number. Okay. Yeah. So he was confirmed to help me after surgery, like take me home after surgery. Mm-hmm. I don't know if he's still in Philly. I don't know if he's still doing the gig in Philly. It's been 2 years now. I don't know where he's at, but he was not at surgery with me. And thank God I have amazing friends. My girl stepped in.
Okay, so I mean, because... Yeah. I'm a Sag. You're a Leo.
I am.
I know we have different levels of crazy that's like real different.
Did
you show up in the Bronx? Like,
I did not. I did not.
Felt in your heart like,
I was like,
go.
You know
like
what?
Frozen. Like,
I was like,
go.
You know what? You don't want this. Mm. I no longer want this. So that is cool. Anyone that doesn't care about like your health, you got to really look at that, right? So it's bad enough that you ghosted me, right? Like that was immature enough, right? Mm-hmm. Like I'm in like my early 30s. Like stop playing, right? It's bad enough that you ghosted me. Now you don't give a damn about my health either. Thanks. I'm good. Yeah, I haven't heard from him.
You never like no reply. No. Did you follow him on Instagram? Like, do you see that he's alive?
You know,
like,
I did closer to the time. Uh-huh. And yeah, he was out like, you know, at a steakhouse, like living up.
Okay.
You know? So yeah, he's alive. I know that. I just know that he did not show up to surgery. No. He can go on about his little life and maybe that's coming from just I don't have time for the bullshit, right? Because that was bullshit, right? If you're not gonna show up to a surgery,
giving him a lot of benefits of the doubt.
That's the thing. My friends were like, you was really like being like, okay, nah, let him practice, and he hit me with it. He was like, you know, like no one complains if like Jay-Z got a. I'm like, cause he's Jay-Z. He's actually working on real shit. What are you? No shade, but like, what are you doing? Are you working on a mixtape that I don't know about? Like, tell me what's up. Like, what are you doing?
Every day I think is a bit excessive, but I do like the fact that he has some discipline. You
he
know,
was
but
very
if you are
disciplined.
Getting like super serious and like, I'll be like, hey, let me bring my laptop over here. But it seems like he has a very specific.
He had a very specific regimen, and I get it.
I need that regimen.
I get. He was very smart. He was an engineer before he became a DJ.
Okay,
so he wasn't a dumb dude. Mm-hmm. He just did dumb shit, and mm-hmm. I would be like, this makes no sense. Mm-hmm. I would be like, do you think this makes sense? Because I don't think it makes sense. Mm-hmm. So when I got ghosted, I was like, we good.
How many times before did you like realize like, okay, I'm not doing this
like,
anymore? Then did you do like the block? Did you, or you just were like,
I mean, you know, remember his phone's always doing not disturb. So I don't even know if he was getting my text messages. You know, he's crazy, right? I don't know. So, I was like, you know what? Cause like once you kind of fuck me over, mm-hmm. I'm good. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to come back for seconds. You know what I mean?
Mm. And back for seconds.
You know
bars.
What I'm saying? Yeah. I like that. I'm not, we're not going to do this. I'm not going to chase you. I'm about to have surgery. You know what I'm saying? Like I didn't need that stress. And he just kind of stressed me out by just not saying anything, showing up.
Right.
So that kind of show, like people, sh- Oprah says people will show you who they are. You have mm-hmm. to believe them. Mm-hmm. And that first time he was like, I got to go because I have to go practice in the morning. I should have known mm-hmm. that something was a little off. It's not mm-hmm. it's not a normal to practice, but mm-hmm. it's like you just met me. It's just like, well, right. You
y'all
already?
Having a good time.
Right.
Yeah.
It's just so that was my last like relationship. Mm-hmm. Before that, I dated this football player. That was also a big waste of my time. And then
well, you were working in sports and stuff.
I was
and
right.
You're
so
an
we
athlete,
that's
so,
how
yeah.
we met. We were working in sports. He was an athlete, but you know the life of the girlfriend of an athlete, you have to kind of be a specific kind. You have to know what it is. You kind of have to know what it is.
I have never dated any professional athlete. Don't. And I think literally 90% of my friends have.
Really?
And I'm like, I don't know how I dodged that bullet or whatever, but I have heard just about of like just painfulness that they've had.
It's painful.
Dealt with.
It's painful because it's just they're on the road. You don't know who they're, you know, and it's a lot of like, oh, is he okay? Or is he here to call me? It's a lot of that. And I'm not really like that chick. You know mm-hmm. what I'm saying? Like, I don't need this life particularly. I'd rather just step away and let some other girl that wants to deal with this. So,
right.
Not specifics of anything, but it was just a lot of drama, a lot of women.
So what you looking for now? Because I like to hook people up.
Oh God.
I just said someone on a blind date. So let me see. I did. Really? That's a whole nother topic. That's a whole nother show. Because I have a whole topic that I'm thinking of doing called the Reform Fuckboy.
Can you reform them?
That's what I want to talk about. I mean, you have to first identify that you are have fuckboy ways.
Right.
So I'm putting I think he's reformed.
Okay.
And he's ready and his mind is in the right place. Mm-hmm. So I was like, you know, and a girl who I did not know that well. Mm. So I said, you know what? Let me see how this goes.
How did it go?
I don't know. They're still going on dates. Second date.
Oh, really? Oh, okay.
See? So, I have a couple of weddings under my belt. And they're still married.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
okay.
So I'm trying to just, you know, keep the party going. I like to spread love the Brooklyn way. You know what I mean? So what you like? What you want real quick before you...
Oh, you know, no one's asked me this in a long time.
Why has no one asked... Who are your friends?
You know, because I think it's just been dad passing and business. Right.
They're not thinking about
that. They're not
that.
Thinking about right, it. Right. And like, neither am I. I mean, I think someone that has a genuine, I just want someone that's genuine, mm-hmm. a genuine heart, someone that has their shit together. Mm-hmm. That's, I know that's sad to, that has to be it, but you need to have your shit together.
Listen, but that's subjective too, because
and that's subjective, right?
Right, because right. like the person I'm like thinking of, like he's not like rich in any sense, but
right,
like really trying to get his shit together, like
right.
just really got his own place, and then like really has got, you know, like it's not rich, but like I have goals to buy a house and to be debt free in a
year.
I
need goals,
and
right.
I like that
ambition.
You know? So
ambition.
I appreciate those things, like, you know, getting yourself together in a way of like, you know, I was here, but now I want to be there.
Right.
That's just having it together. I think sometimes opposed right. to like, well, you got to make, you know, this amount of money or be
yeah.
a millionaire. You know,
yeah, it's not that about mm-hmm. that. I think like sometimes as women be like, oh, we want a millionaire, blah, blah, blah. But it's not really about that anymore, because I think sometimes we're taught that like you just have to marry a man with money. Mm. But that necessarily doesn't make you happy all the time.
It doesn't.
It's really more mm-hmm. about now like the partnership of someone mm-hmm. is what I'm really looking for. Specifically now that I've lost someone that mm-hmm. and fathers is very different than like a relationship. But, you know, they say that we date our fathers mm. or we find traits. Yeah.
Listen, it's so true. And for me, yeah. I mean, my father was a musician mm. and he's a Sagittarius. Our birthdays are a day apart. I mean, mm. we were freaking frack. Like,
right, right.
Very, very similar. And I cannot date me. Nope. And right. But the guys who I've always like fawned over or like, oh my gosh, he's so great. Mm-hmm. They were just messes.
Mm-hmm. right.
I love this mess. I just want to clean it all up.
Right.
No, but those weren't. Or like, I just love creative men. So like that's, you know, if your dad was either very good with money or creative or
right.
like you said, things, you said your dad was really big on education.
Right. He was really big on education, and like he was really big on like, you know, he always tell me every day, you're a beautiful girl. And so I knew.
That's so nice.
You know, so I felt like.
So you like a guy to probably say that to you.
I didn't
think about it as much as now, like, just seeing it in other people, in other relationships. Like,
yeah.
You know, just that random, like, you're beautiful. I'm like,
yeah.
Okay. Or it's a person nice. Who never said it. And I'm right. like.
Why? You ain't going to say nothing? You see, I look cute today.
I just got a whole new hairstyle.
Right. And they don't say nothing. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But I think, like, my dad, like, loved me unconditional. And mm-hmm. I want a man that's going to appreciate who I am mm-hmm. inside and out. You know mm-hmm. what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And that sometimes is hard to find. You know, and again, I don't need rich. I need ambition. Mm-hmm. I need goals mm-hmm. because I have ambition and I have goals and mm-hmm. I kind of want that the same. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So that's.
And I'm just letting y'all know if you're not on YouTube, she looks so much like SZA. I'm like looking at her.
Why does everyone say that to me? Like,
she has the straight long hair now. And I'm like, you need to be scissor for Halloween. Oh my
That is a
goodness.
Good idea. I didn't even think about
yes,
that.
Yes.
Oh my God.
I'm looking at her and I'm like, holy cow. So, you know,
that's like the third
scissor fans out
that's
there.
That's like the third time
looking
someone
for
said
a
that.
Young, successful young thing. You better slide in her.
Don't come to my. No,
you better
don't
slide
in
her
DMs.
DM. Look, I'll give you the message, okay?
Just so wait a minute, you're trying to hook me up. What about you?
What about me? We are
no. What is we ain't wrapped up.
Thank you for tuning in.
What about you? Are you dating? What's going?
Well, as we're talking about career, relationships, overall health. Yes, I am. I'm doing my thing. I am finding my ways with my career, my relationship, my overall health, and I'm happy in them.
Okay.
My career I'm working on, that's so, like, you know, it's a lot, but
right
I'm finding contentment in everything mm-hmm. like really, like, this mm-hmm. feels good. Now there's days it's better than others.
I
can always just like $1 million more mm-hmm. in my bank account, but
of course
you know what I'm just, and that's the purpose of this podcast is mm-hmm. to really find the balance in your career, relationships, overall health. Like, what does that relationship look like to you? Like, what does that person do? How do they talk? And really mm. speaking it into existence. And that's why I like to, like, talk to people about that, to say, like, what do you want? Because if you can see it, it's like, you can see it, then you can achieve it.
That's true.
Just like it's
that's
fitness, true. Bish. You manifested it.
That's
and now
true.
It's come to life. Yeah. I manifest the person that it doesn't matter. I'm not going to find everything. And even with your company, you know,
right.
you may either grow too fast or too slow. You may grow at the right pace. You may have right. those things, but you're probably okay as long as you have it in the way that you see fit.
That's
you know?
True. That's
so
true.
Just like that with your health. I mean, if you want to be a size zero, that's your goal. I mean, yeah, but you know what? If I'm healthy, that's what's more important to
Absolutely.
Me. So I think finding the contentment in those. So, like, for the first time, I would say, like, I'm really, like, feel good about those things.
Good,
so
good, good.
But I'm trying to keep manifesting the right things. I'm going to manifest some more money. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So I can be rich and then we can take the Music Men and My Mentor on tour.
Right, right. Oh, and that would be amazing.
Right. Well, I can't wait for us to co-brand together.
Yes,
especially.
Absolutely.
So you guys
absolutely.
Be on the lookout, especially in 2020.
Absolutely.
And I want people to really go on your website. It's,
yes.
it's fitnessbitch.com.
It's fitnessbitch.com. Be fun, be fearless, be fabulous. That's mm-hmm. our mantra. Mm-hmm. We get information for the holidays. We're actually going to be doing our holiday my workout shit bag. Mm-hmm. That's going to be coming for December. And then top
I have the bag.
You do yes. have the bag. I gave her the
it
bag.
It says my workout shit, right?
Right, because it is your workout shit. That's what your bag's
yes,
for.
Yes, yes, yes.
And in the top of the year, we're going to do a 30-day challenge. So look out for that. That's going to be coming soon. And hopefully going to be DJing a lot of our classes in the coming
I cannot
year.
Wait.
And house is, party workshops.
Yes. Yeah. Oh my goodness. I can't wait.
Yeah.
To, like, these house party workshops, they sound so cool. It's mm-hmm. fitness. It's a, you say you rent out a house. Like,
yeah, we try to rent
cocktails,
out beautiful
fitness.
Homes in New York, and we invite amazing people. We have drinks. We're going to have a DJ. Mm-hmm. And then we're going to do cooking demonstrations to kind of show you different ways to cook, whether mm-hmm. it's the topic could be vegetarianism or proteins mm-hmm. or, you know, how to cook corn better a million ways. Mm-hmm. And you get to taste all the food. You get menus. You get mm-hmm. Meal plans to take home with you. Mm-hmm. And then after that, you kind of mingle and have a good time. Like, it's a party.
I love it.
Yeah. So we're we're excited.
And where can we find you on Instagram, the Twitter, the
yes.
social medias?
So Instagram is Fitness Bitch. New York mm-hmm. NY, and then my personal @ it's Fitness Bitch Kiki QUIQUI. Twitter saying Fit Bitch NY. Facebook, Fitness Bitch NY. So
Fit Bitch NY.
Fitness Bitch NY.
Gotcha.
Fitness Bitch NY.
Well,
yes.
God,
yes.
Thank you for being on the
well,
show.
Well, thank you. This was amazing. This was amazing. Yeah. And I'm so happy I met you. Thank you for just
when
giving
I
me the chance to.
It just was ordained.
Yes, it kind of was. It kind of was. Yeah.
So yeah, so look out for us and thank you for tuning in. Like, subscribe. You know what to do at Music Men and My Mental. And the website is up. Music Men at, www.musicmenandmymental.com. So make sure you go on there, find out all the latest podcasts, past podcasts, and more. So thank you. I'm C. DeVone. Thank you to my guest.
Thank you for having me. Thank you so much.
All right. Bye.
Bye.
Later.